Hi everyone and welcome back. In this video we are going to talk about an important aspect of the nest cells, which is interceptors. Okay, so first of all, what is interceptors? Okay, we are going to write one, like we have already have this exception filter. Similarly, we will also write these interceptors. So suppose you have an application which is doing the authentication mechanism. Okay, you are getting this token in the authorization header. So what you are doing is you are doing the pre-processing, pre-check of the token exists in the authorization or not, right? So you are doing some pre-processing before executing the request itself. Similarly, there is another thing, like you got the response and you wanted to do the log of that response which you are sending to the client. It means you are doing the post-processing but before sending the response to the client. So I mean, there is no any problem, we can do it with the simple code, but you have to add this logic in each and every route. What if we can add this as a middleware, right? So there is a middleware is already a concept, but there is also another concept is interceptor, which intercepts your request before it handled to the server and intercept the response before you send the response back to the client. Okay, so it's like a bit of an additional logic which is being executed before and after of method execution. It's like a, you can also, like it can be a simple logger where you are logging the user agent which is coming for the request and the response object which you are sending to the client. Okay, this can be like, what are the different use case of the interceptor pattern? Transform the result which is being returned, transform the exception which is being thrown. Simple example is exception filter, that is doing nothing but transforming the response being received by the client, right? So in the next years, we can actually create one and let's see how it is. So we can create logger interceptor.ts, and what this interceptor will be, it will be injectable service same as any other service. So we'll try to write it from template. So this is a simple nest.js template. It is implementing the nest interceptor, and here we have to implement one method. You can see implement nest this intercept method, right? So this intercept method is doing nothing but it is intercepting the execution context and it is calling the next. So once your execution context is done, you will call next.handle. So what we are going to do inside this particular method is we are going to write this intercept method. Intercept method will do nothing but let's say our use case is we wanted to print the user agent which is coming for the request, right? I will just add this code snippet from the nest.js documentation, but this is like what we are doing, intercepting. Here we are getting the request user agent, we are logging the time and we are handling this. So we are using this rxjs pipe, whatever the request we are getting, we are handling it and we are sending it. So we are actually capturing the user agent string from the browser or from the postman, whoever is sending it, and we can calculate the execution time of the request which is raised, right? So this is the now, date.now minus now means, I mean, this will execute before the request and after you send the response. So we are capturing the now, and once the response is being received, we will capture the current time minus the date time which is recorded once the request is arrived and the user agent, right? So you can actually use your the custom logger or the logger which is provided by the nest.js and log it, right? So it is nothing but a specific logic which we are adding. Now how to plug this in with your controllers and with the whole application? So if you wanted to put it with the controller, like we have these controllers, user controller, we can attach this at the controller level by using use interceptor. So you just import these missing things. Okay, so this is how we can add this, or you can also add this to the application level. So this is same, use interceptor, use pipe, use guards, these kind of similar names. And when you have to register these, you can also register all these things at the application level on the app instance. So what we do is before starting the application, we can use app.use global interceptor, app.use global pipes. I will just import this, but I will show you all the methods which are available there. Use You can see global guards, global interceptor, global filters, logger, right? So when you wanted to put things at the global level, you can use this methods, global guards, global interceptor, global filters, right? So we can use a global interceptors and provide our new logger interceptor. New interceptor, something like this, and we'll just import this. And you can also add it at a module level, okay? But we have already have added it to the controller, that should be fine. So this is the story about the interceptor and very important concept for the NestJS developers, okay? Thanks everyone.